Good day, dear students. I'm Adegbite OOB Mrs. of Counseling Unit under Student Affairs Division for NAB Abeokuta. I'll be taking you social relationship among students on campus, chastity and associated challenges. At the end of the presentation, you'll be able to have understanding of what campus relationship should be, know when you should be involved in sexual relationship, know what chastity is all about, understand God's mind about chastity, know advantages of chastity, know the associated challenges of being chaste, learn how to be chaste, have knowledge of sex education. What is relationship? Relationship is the way in which two or more people are connected or state of being connected. As we are here on campus, you will have reasons to be connected with people. You relate with other students like yourself. And that is why you need to know what is expected of you and the kind of relationship you should be involved in. You should be on the lookout for healthy relationship. And how do you know healthy relationship? It must have feeling of safety, honesty, open communication, mutual respect, acceptance, and enjoyment. It should not be a relationship that makes you look inferior or intimidated. The relationship you are to engage yourself in should not be a relationship that will want to force you to do what you don't want to do. You must understand all these things because the kind of healthy relationship is the only relationship that will help you out as you are here on campus. The essence of this presentation is to inform you before it is too late so that your stay on campus will not be affected. You will finish well. And that's why we are bringing this information to you now. We don't want you to make mistakes that others have made in the past. When you are in a wrong relationship, it has a way of affecting your academics, and it has a way of determining what happens to you at the end of the program. We don't want you to get withdrawn from the university, and we don't want you to finish with third class or just pass. So we want you to finish well. That's the essence of this. So relationship is very, very important. The kind of relationship you are into is very, very important. You have to understand that now as you're coming in as fresh students. And we have different types of relationship. I'll be talking on sexual relationship because you need to be very aware of sexual relationship, and you need to know now that you are not to be engaged in sexual relationship. What do I mean by sexual relationship? Relationship involving sexual intimacy. You don't need it for now. You should understand that. It has a way of hurting you. And by the time you are hurt, you'll be affected. You'll be disturbed emotionally. And once you are disturbed emotionally, you cannot read and assimilate. You'll be affected in a way that your studies will be affected. And that's why you see many students, they will tell you, I used to read. By the time we dipped him into what the problem is, we discovered that one way or the other, they'd be involved in relationship that is affecting them. That's why we are bringing this information to you. I'm telling you this again because we don't want you to have problem in your academics. And that's your primary assignment here. You always have to remember that your primary assignment on campus is to come and study, learn, and acquire more knowledge. Don't forget that. So, sexual relationship, you are not supposed to be involved in it now. Leave it for married people. Leave it till later in life. Leave it till when you will be celebrated with it. So, and in order to help you with this sexual relationship, I'll be talking on chastity. If you understand what chastity is all about and you embrace it, it's going to help you to handle sexual relationship because there's no way. It will come to you. Suggestions will come to you. Pressures will come to you to be involved in sexual relationship. How do you handle it? If you know about chastity and you determine to be chaste, it's going to help you to handle sexual relationship. What is chastity? You can see from this picture, chastity is something very good to behold. Pure. You can see it. You can define chastity as sexual self-control, sexual purity. Chastity means not having any sexual relations before marriage. That is the way God has designed sex to be. It should be for married people. And we can see that in the Bible and in the Quran. God talks about it in the Bible, the holy book of God, and also the holy book of God, the Quran. In 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 9, it says, "Or do you not know that unrighteous persons will not inherit God's kingdom? Do not be misled. Those who are sexually immoral will not inherit God's kingdom." Verse 18 of that chapter says, "Flee from sexual immorality." If we are asked to flee from it, flee from sexual immorality. In chapter 7, verse 1 and 2, it says, "It is better for a man not to touch a woman, but because of prevalence of sexual immorality, let each man have his own wife and each woman have her own husband." Are you ready to be married? Are you married now, or are you ready to be married? If you are not married, you are a student, you are not planning to get married now. So don't plan to be involved in sexual harassment. Face your studies now. Everything has its own time. The time now you are into now is to study and to acquire more knowledge. Also, in the holy book of God, Quran, Quran chapter 17, verse 32 also talks about sexual immorality. It says, "And do not approach unlawful sexual intercourse. Indeed, it is ever an immorality, and it is evil as a way." That is Quran telling us that unlawful sexual intercourse is evil. There is no other name you can give to it. It is evil. Don't be involved in it. It is evil. We are encouraged that if anybody wants to be involved in sexual immorality, he should be married. God has plan for sex. Sex itself is not bad. That's the fact. It's created by God and it's wonderful. But God gave operating instructions for sex. It's in the Bible and it's in the Quran as we have read it. We have to obey God's law. And that's the only thing that can bring God's joy. Obeying God's law brings happiness and, you know, safety unto us. We have to obey God's law. We are not to be involved in sex when we are not married. We have so many advantages of chastity. Chastity prevents you from hurt. You will not be hurt. You will not have any regrets. You will not have to, you know, you will not have to have reasons to be worried. You don't have reasons to be worried of transmitted diseases, unwanted pregnancy. No, chastity is 100% effective, 100% healthy, and 100% economical choice. There is nothing, when you talk of sexual relationship, chastity is the best choice that you can have. You know, chastity, you don't have with chastity, no trauma of abortion, no pressure to marry early or to marry the wrong person. Somebody, because you have been involved, you've involved yourself with sex with the person, you have to marry the person by force. No, you won't have to do that if you embrace chastity. Chastity is not something like a jacket that you can put on or take off whenever you like it. If you want to be chaste, it has to be part and parcel of you. You must be known for it. Everything about you must communicate it. Anytime, any day, the words of your mouth, your actions, everything has to communicate chastity. Modesty is one important way to express chastity. You have to be modest. The type of clothes you are wearing, everything has to be modest. And also, to be chaste, you have to learn to say no, because pressure will definitely come. You will definitely be introduced into sexual harassment, sexual relationship. So you have to, if you want to be chaste, if you don't want to involve yourself in it, you have to learn to say no. Learning to say no, you must understand three kinds of language: verbal language, body language, and clothes language. What do I mean by this? For your no to mean no, all these three languages must be saying the same thing at the same time. For example, A girl can say no with words, but her tight skirt and skippy blouse are saying yes. Look at these pictures now. Look at these ladies. Look at what they are wearing. Even if they are saying no from now to tomorrow, can anybody believe that what they mean is no? No, because the type of clothes they are wearing is saying yes. So they cannot be taken serious even with the words of their mouth. If you want to embrace chastity, everything about you must be saying no if you are saying no. Look at these ones too. This type of clothes can never say no, and nobody will take them serious. Look at these ones. The expression, the look on the lady's face is saying yes, even though she's saying, the look is saying yes, even though the words of her mouth is saying no, she can never be taken serious. The words of her mouth is already saying yes. So if you want to say no, everything about you, your actions, your words, everything must be saying no. Look at this lady looking sexy. Some of you ladies, you love to be called sexy. You can't be dressing sexy, wearing provocative dresses, and you want to tell anybody you don't want to be involved in sexual relationship. It won't carry weight. You will not be taken serious. So everything about you must say no. Modesty in dress, speech, and action is a virtue that applies to everybody, men as well as women. Guys, I'm very sure by now you must have learned the dress code for this university. Modesty is one of the things that we embrace in this university, and it's for your own good. By the time you dress modestly and the words of your mouth, your actions, everything is expressed modestly, you will help yourself academically. Number one, you will not be hurt. Number two, emotionally you will be stable. And if you are stable emotionally, you will study well, you will assimilate well, and when exam comes, you'll be able to perform well. Guys, you need to make decisions. Ladies, you need to decide now before it is too late. My prayer for you is that it will not be too late for you. You need to be careful now before it is too late. Learning to say no. You have to be prepared psychologically, because temptations will come, advice will come, suggestions will come, pressure will come. So it's good for you now to start preparing yourself psychologically how to handle pressure when pressure comes. Remember, a lie demands a comeback that can put an end to the pressure once and for all, and really communicate your strong no. I'll give you examples of how to prepare yourself psychologically for pressure so that the pressure will not overcome you. For example, if you are asked, "Don't you love me?" you can give answer like, "I love you enough to say no." If you really love me, you would. Your answer, if you really love me, you wouldn't ask. If you really care about somebody, you don't pressure them to do something they don't want to do. Everybody is doing it. Then answer something like, "Everybody but me." Really, everybody is doing it. You can give your response as, "Then you shouldn't have any trouble finding somebody else. Don't you find me attractive?" Tell the person, "I find you very attractive. I like you a lot. That's why I don't want to wreck our relationship by getting too physical." If the person comes to you like, "I will stop whenever you say," tell the person, "How about right now?" If you are being pressurized, "I love you," then you can say, "Then please prove it by respecting my values. What are you waiting for?" Answer the person, "I'm waiting for the person I will marry. Are you repressed or something?" A good answer will be, "No, I'm free from pressure to have sex before I get married." even if the person will insist and say, sex isn't a big deal, tell him, it's a big deal to me, a big deal to my future husband or wife, and a big deal to God. And I made a promise, I will wait. If you do all these things, if you prepare your mind like this, you know, it will not meet you unaware. You'll be well prepared. And I want to tell you, if you answer somebody like this, let me tell you, even though the person might not say it to your face, the person will respect you, even for life. So you have to be prepared and you have to understand what I have to say no. Another thing for you to know when you want to be chaste is the kind of friends you keep. Choosing friends who share your values is very, very important. Research and evaluation found that teens who had friends who are resolved to abstain from premarital sex were significantly more likely to remain chaste than teens who did not have supportive friends. The kind of friends you keep will determine if your determination to remain chaste will work out or not. If you have friends that embrace chastity, they will encourage you to be chaste. If you have friends that are into sexual relationships, sexual immorality, sexual intimacy, they will influence you. You will find it difficult to be chaste yourself. So beware of the kind of friends you keep. The right kind of sex education is another thing you should know. There are two kinds of sex education. One kind says, don't have sex, but if you can't abstain, be responsible and practice safe sex. Use a condom. But I want to tell you, it has a mixed message. And also a false one. Since condoms don't make sex safe, Know that. The second sex education is chastity based. Abstaining from sexual intimacy before marriage is the only medically safe, emotionally healthy, and morally responsible choice. Condoms don't make sex physically safe. You can still get pregnant or catch a disease. Condoms don't make sex emotionally safe. You can still get hurt. Condoms don't make sex ethically loving. You can't claim to love somebody if you are gambling with their health and happiness. Chastity is the best way to prepare for a happy, faithful, and lasting marriage. Don't forget that. If you haven't been chaste in the past, you can decide to practice chastity from this point now. It is never too late. It is never too late. In conclusion, I want to give you some tips in order not to awaken love before it's time. You don't want to be involved in it, then don't try to go near it. Don't stay alone with opposite sex in secluded places. Do not visit to spend nights or weekends in opposite sex house, no matter the pressure. Do not wear provocative clothes to the opposite sex house, especially ladies. Always remember that a man is moved by sight, by what they see. Be careful the way you dress. Be careful of the way you dress. Do not be suggestive in any way. Be calm and you'll be found. Rest in God. Believe in God. God has a plan for you. Avoid touching opposite sex intimately. It could lead to what will be regrettable. Avoid kissing, petting, so that you not, you know, be called weak. For those of you friends out there that are still virgins, you don't need to lose your virginity. Simply give it to your husband or your wife. And for those of you that are no longer virgins, don't continue to do what is wrong. It's never too late to stop doing what is wrong and start doing what is right. Thank you very much for listening.